Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to answer any Murmur question without even reading the vignette, just by reading the description of the Murmur or by seeing a video of the Murmur, you will be able to answer the question. Let's get started. So number one, guys, when you wanna answer a Murmur question quickly is look, where is the Murmur? Whether it's a video or a description of the Murmur location, where is it best heard will tell you which valve is affected. If the question says the Murmur is best heard over the right second intercostal space, then he's talking about the aortic valve. If he tells you the Murmur is best heard over the left second space or upper left sternal border, that means the pulmonic valve is affected. If he says the Murmur is best heard over the apex, then it's the mitral valve that's affected, or the fifth space. So now that you know which valve is affected based on the description of the Murmur, the next step is to know whether it's systole, is it stenosis or regurgitation. And that would be through answering the second question, when is the Murmur? So where is the Murmur tells you which valve is it? Is it aortic, mitral, tricuspid, pulmonary? And number two, the second question, when is the Murmur systolic or diastolic, will tell you the type of lesion in this valve. Is it aortic stenosis or regurgitation? Okay, so those two, if you answer those two questions, you will be able to figure out any heart murmur. So let me show you how to do that, guys. Now that we answered the question, where is the murmur best heard? Now you know which valve is affected, aortic, pulmonary, mitral, tricuspid. Now we need to know, is it stenosis or regurgitation? What's wrong with this valve? Then you need to know, when is the murmur? During, if it's the murmur systolic or is it diastolic? During systole, which valves should be open? The aortic and pulmonary. Meaning if they are stenotic, that will cause a murmur. Now, which valve should be closed during systole? Mitral and tricuspid. So if they are incompetent or regurgitant, then that will cause a murmur. So now, if he tells you the murmur is best heard over the second space, that's the aortic area, now I know it's the aortic valve that's affected. Now, is it stenosis or regurgitation? Look, when is it heard? If it's systolic, I know the valve should be open during systole, so it must be aortic stenosis. And so on so forth. All right, guys, I'm here on Ambus and this is the first time I see this question with you, so I'm gonna go as usual here. Since he's not showing me a description of the murmur, then I'll have to see the video. Here I'm starting to listen where the murmur is best heard, because where it's maximum will tell me the valve affected. You can see here, guys, that it was best heard in the mitral area at the apex. So now I know this is a mitral murmur. So I'm gonna choose a murmur that is mitral, and you heard it, guys, best during systole. So this must be, which valve is the mitral valve should be closed during systole. So if it's incompetent, that will cause a murmur. So it should be mitral regurgitation. again. So where is the murmur and when is it heard tells me everything, and I did not even read the question. Now, which valve should open during diastole? It's the mitral and tricuspid valve should open during diastole. And so if they are stenotic, that will cause a diastolic murmur. Now, which valve should be closed during diastole? Aortic and pulmonary. And so if they are incompetent or regurgitant, that will cause a diastolic murmur. So this, guys, is how to answer murmur questions. Number one, where is the murmur? Will tell you which valve is affected. Let's say it's mitral over the apex. Then it's gonna tell you it's systolic or diastolic. First, you need to figure out which valve should open during diastole to fill the heart. It must be mitral and tricuspid. And so if the murmur is diastolic, then the mitral must be stenotic or narrow. Now, what if the murmur happens all through systole and diastole? That indicates that there is a continuous flow all through, which means there is no valve involved actually, because the flow is continuous all through the cardiac cycle. It's not that at this phase there is one valve that should be closed or should be open. It means there is no valve. And that's in case of patent ductus arteriosus. Now, some questions, guys, do not actually show you a murmur. Rather, they show you an extra heart sound. And whenever you see extra heart sounds, they must be diastolic. Because you know, guys, the S1, which is LUP, is due to closure of the mitral valves after diastole, and the start of systole, right? And then, so this is S1, followed by systole. And then DUP, which is the second heart sound, is due to closure of the aortic and pulmonary valves. And then we start diastole. So anything extra after S2 is a diastolic extra sound. Could be S3, early diastole, or S4, late diastole. Now, S3, early diastole, during the passive filling phase, is because of congestion, as if we are splashing quickly to fill the heart. It's a splash, right? Which means there is congestion here. There is extra end systolic volume from the previous cycle or previous beat. So that could be in cases of congestive heart failure or hyperdynamic circulation like pregnancy. And we usually, you know, hear this as the state Kentucky. Hear it like this. Kentucky. Okay? While S4, which also happens in diastole, but that's in late diastole, during the atrial kick, while the atrium is contracting to squeeze the remaining blood into the left ventricle, this is mainly caused by a stiff left ventricle. What could possibly cause a stiff left ventricle? Any hypertrophy will cause a stiff ventricle and S4. Hypertrophy could be due to hypertension, and that's very high yield. Whenever you see a murmur question, you have to look at the blood pressure. So hypertension causes hypertrophy and a stiff heart, which causes an extra S4. Or it could be aortic stenosis, which causes an extra S4 as well, in addition to the stenosis murmur, right? Or it could be something that is restricting the heart because of extra filling here. That could be restrictive cardiomyopathy because of extra substance, right? Which could be amyloid. Anything causing a stiff left ventricle will make it the flow turbulent while we are pushing the atrial kick, and that will be in late diastole. And we usually hear it as the state Tennessee.